What's going on, boys? Welcome back to the Sunderland Road to Glory career mode. Let's get it popping then today. Here we are in the most hectic, most difficult, but most exciting point of the season, the month of December in the Premier League. It is ruthless. 4 weeks, but 8 games crammed into those 4 weeks. A lot of points to be won or lost. At the moment, we sit pretty. 8th place, 19 points. Very, very good indeed. But just 9 points between us and the bottom three. At the moment, those spots are occupied by our biggest rivals, Newcastle, rock bottom, Southampton, and West Ham United, shockingly, in 18th place. Today, boys, though, this league table will be absolutely twisting and turning throughout. It will look so different come the end of the episode, so strap yourselves in for an epic episode of goals, games, and highlights. The highlight of the season so far has been signing Gelhardt, top scorer in the league, more goals than Salah, more than Ronaldo, more than Kane. He is the elite striker in this division at the moment, and he plays for Sunderland. Let's see how he gets on today. Our first game then, Southampton away. Smallbone on the edge of the area. He's got away from his man. Oh, the marking is so bad. Oh, this God. Why is no one marking? They're just standing and watching, and Southampton gets the opening goal of this game. It's so simple, isn't it? That is shocking defending. Seriously! I would say Doyle is the closest defender, but really, it should have been Mitoglou. It is his man to get, and he was nowhere to be seen. Jed Spence, for some reason, is right inside the two centre-backs, our right wing-back. Hasenhüttl's buzzing because Southampton score the first goal and have the lead. Lukic inside to Smallbone, who's had a really good game. Cabral nearly fell over Mitoglou here, who is having a bit of a shocker in this game, to be honest, at the back. Riley now needs to pick his pass. Decides to go out wide to Sirkin, the left wing back. Good delivery, please. Backstick. Gelhardt! Yes! Super Gelhardt gets the goal! 1-1! We're back level, boys! Gelhardt is on fire in the Premier League. Leeds United sold him to Bayern Munich. Bayern Munich sold him to Sunderland. And he's come alive for Sunderland. Let's go, mate! What a delivery, though, from Sirkin. Brilliant header. And we're back level. Southampton working it well in our final third at the moment. Goes back to Smallbone. Had a brilliant game. I've said that a few times, haven't I? Janssen back towards Smallbone, who's dictating the play in the midfield. But Rida steps forward and wins the ball. We need a run. We need a run, please, boys. Somebody make a good run for me. Riley is that man. I found him. Riley, can he get the finish? Oh! Riley! Let's go! Captain Fantastic, Peter Riley! Sunderland back from being 1-0 down, now 2-1 up! Yes! Let's go! This team is absolutely loving it in the Premier League at the moment. That's a great hit. Keeper couldn't get across. Buries it! 2-1! Oh, he's done, mate. He's done Jed Spence there. Really poor defending, really, from Spence. Mitoglou gives away the free kick. It was looking worse than that. I'm happy for him to commit the foul out there. And we as well can get on our subs. Completely forgot about them. I was totally in the game. Smallbone comes off. He was brilliant today. Diallo comes on. You'll see we'll make triple changes. Riley, Detardian, Gilhart off. Lloyd, Arroyo and Stewart on for the final few moments of this game. We're going to be very tired because in 2 days' time, we have to play Arsenal. But Arroyo's just come on. He's got a lot of energy, a lot of pace. The young Brazilian from the youth academy is in behind. He scores. What a substitution that is. Yes. What a result this will be. It looked disastrous. We went 1-0 down. But my goodness me, have we fought back. 3-1 now. What a substitution. Look at the team spirit. Let's go. The red and the white of Southampton have been beaten by the yellow and blue of the away Sunderland team. Great finish from our number 40. Our number 30 even, Eduardo Arroyo. Come on! Let's go, boys. And that is how it ends. A brilliant ending to what looked to be a difficult game. Gelhardt got another goal for his tally. He's projected to potentially be one of the best goal scorers in the Premier League this season. Today ends, though. Sunderland 3, Southampton 1. And here we go then, straight in to our next game. Joe Gelhardt, we've been speaking about him, it feels like all episodes so far, but why not? He's been brilliant. Today we're back at home at the Stadium of Light and we invite Arsenal for a mega clash. Few changes to the team, just a 2-day turnaround, so some tired legs out there. Bella Kotchap comes in at the back. Lloyd comes in for Riley in attacking midfield. And goal scorer right at the end of the last one, Arroyo in for Samuel Lambert. Let's do this today, boys. We take on the Gunners. Tavares trying to knock it past Spence. Spence does well, uses his pace and his ability. Reader's ball forward. Arroyo's making a great run. We may have Arsenal open here. Arroyo's delivery is key. It's a good one. And it's also... Oh, it's gone in! Yes! I thought it would go in initially. It was saved by Ramsdale. But the rebound found its way home. Tatarian is claiming it. I'm not sure if it's his goal or an own goal. We'll have to check that replay. But at the Stadium of Light, Arsenal 0, Sunderland 1. Let's go. Let's check this out. So, a good delivery. Initially a great save. It's an own goal. And it's Pablo Mari. It's a great save by Ramsdale. Smashes off Mari's arm, in fact. And it goes in. Yes! We're beating Arsenal, boys. We're beating Arsenal. Wow. Oh, Arsenal really playing some good stuff here in and around our box. Well, our lead didn't last very bloody long, did it? Goal for Arsenal. Goal for Silva. He goes and celebrates with Mikel Arteta. They have a really good striker here at Arsenal in this career mode. Andre Silva. He gets the ball in the back of the net. Didn't need long. Smashes it past Collins. No chance. All level again. Reader, well done, mate. Bad touch to start, but brought it back under control. Cirkin now to Cabral. Oh, great. Few touches by him around the corner. This is Lloyd now, still with Lloyd. We can get a run from Arroyo. Dink it over towards Gelhardt. Oh, what a save by Ramsdale. What? No freaking way he saved that. Wow. Wow, I've got to watch that replay. Flicked on by Gelhardt. Looping over Ramsdale. Fingertip stuff. Just past the post. Wow. What a goalkeeper Ramsdale is. Our corner whipped in. Gelhardt the target. It doesn't drop for him. It's here with Lloyd now on the edge. Still with Lloyd. Goes for goal. I see Ramsdale on the back. It's not gone in. Lloyd, oh, he's so bloody unlucky. How unlucky have we been? Wow! Oh, it's a really good play from Arsenal. Dinked over to the other wing. Lidio's had a really good game for Arsenal in this one. Tavares has been really decent as well. Spence knocked off the ball by Tavares and Silva scores. Arsenal come from behind, just like we did against Southampton. Arsenal went 1-0 down, but have bounced back in style. Silva especially, him and Arteta clearly got a special relationship. A second hug for his second goal today. Arsenal 2 on the hour mark, Sunderland 1. It's going to be a difficult game this to get back into it and get anything from this one because Arsenal, they look hot. Partey is dominating this midfield, absolutely dominating it. And now Saka's behind Sirkin. I've gone sliding in, I don't know why. It doesn't matter. Tavernier gets the goal for Arsenal's third. 3-1 to the Gunners and that, unfortunately, is that. They're better than us, simple as that. It's absolutely simple as that. Better quality on the ball, better decision making, and lethal finishing touch. Boom. 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 3-1. But the Arsenal players hugging each other for a job well done. The home fans emptied out early. The away fans staying late for sure. Arsenal come from behind to take 3 points away from us. Disappointing in the end, but Arsenal much stronger. On to the next, because today ends in defeat. Arsenal 3, Sunderland 1. Okay, boys, then 2 games played so far, and with a lot to come, we must keep it going. We have to simulate a few games. The next game then against Aston Villa will be one of those matches. Gonna make a few tweaks. Gilhart absolutely on fire, but Stewart deserves a few games here and there. Bello will come in as well. We're going to bring Cook in instead of Reader for this one. Other than that, it will be the strongest possible 11 I believe we have at this stage of the season. Next up then, Aston Villa in the Premier League away from home. We're going to simulate it. We're not going to do a quick sim. We're going to do a normal sim. And any goals, I'll let you know. Good looking attack this. We're dominating the game so far. Can we get the goal? Cabral! First goal of the game goes to Sunderland. Gabriel Cabral, the Brazilian beast in midfield. 70% possession, 6 shots compared to Villa, who have been woeful. We're well on top, and now we have our 1-goal lead. Bruh. Why do we get so many freaking injuries in this career mode, man? We have had so many big injuries. I pray to God this is just a little one. Serkin comes in. Bello gets a chance to play today. And typically he gets injured. But we've done a quick free kick. And Stewart scores. Yes! Talk about medicine. I was hurt from that injury. But we've bounced in and got the second. Just before the break, Stewart gets the goal. Come on. Woo! Final 5 minutes, boys. Hang in there. 2-goal lead. Another clean sheet would be really nice. Haven't had that many recently, but today could be the day. Villa coming forward, but not able to find their way to goal. A corner for Villa. Headed clear. Referee, get your whistle out. Referee, give us the result, please. Please, please. Yes! Big win for Sunderland. Another away win in the Premier League. We beat Aston Villa 2-0. Super Stewart gets his chance up front today. Got the goal. Cabral scored. An injury to Bello. The only bad thing from this. What a performance. And it is a pretty bad injury, to be fair. I was hoping for just a few days. It's going to be more like a few weeks. At least a month. He's going to be out 4 weeks. We lose Bello, our backup left back. That means Serkin, by the end of December, is going to be absolutely shattered. And when I say shattered, I mean it. More bad news to pile on top of that as well, boys. Lorenzo Pirola, the 21-year-old Italian, one for the future for sure. He's had enough. He wants out of Sunderland. Officially has submitted himself a transfer request. So come around January, Pirola could be on the move. That is really disappointing. Alright then, lads, back in to the next game today at the Stadium of Light. We take on mid-table side Watford, having a decent season as well. Both of us would like 3 points today. A lot of tired players in our squad at the moment. Some changes to be pointed out to you. Bella Kotchap comes in at centre-back. Matheson, who hasn't played in a while, at right-back. But the pick of the bunch, in midfield, young Alvarez. He'll be playing. Cook being rested and Reader being rested as well. So let's do this today. A few changes, but still a big game. Yes, Cabral. Great interception there. That's a good start. I like that. That shows what we're going to be like today. And he gets tackled. He's down, but he gets up. Every time a player goes down at the minute, I'm worried that they're going to stay down. I seem to be getting a lot of injuries in this career mode at the moment. Gilhart is in behind though. Gilhart! Wow! Okoye in goal for Watford. Makes a ridiculously good save. Gilhart strikes it goalbound. I thought that was flying in. What a fingertip save that was. Corner ball whipped in. Riley goes for it. Good ball in, but cleared away. Very, very good start. All right, I said good start, but don't balls it up now. Don't. Honestly, just don't. Please, lads, don't make me eat my words. Well done, Bella Kotchap. That's more like it. That's what I want to see from you. And now we have space. A lot of it. Dottardian closing down on goal. And Dottardian finds the back of the net. Yes, lad, that's more like it. Back on the score sheet for Dottardian, now number 10. Lethal winger, lethal finisher. And we are lethal at the Stadium of Light again. Let's go. Love that counter-attack. It was a good start. And we finally get that goal. Loving this career mode, lads. Smash that like button if you are enjoying it as well. Subscribe if you're new. Daniel Dottardian is on flames. 13 minutes played. We've got that lead. Watford really pressing here, trying to get their level up late in the game now. Well, we must be heading towards the final 10 or 15 minutes. We are inside that period. We've made all three subs, and we're hanging in at the moment. Riley's done really, really well. Maybe a 1-2. Into Stewart. Out wide again here to Dottardian. Looking for a bit of movement if I can get it. I get it out wide to the wing-back. Serkin's delivery is key here. Riley! Oh, no! Big miss by Peter Riley. Really got up well. Ronaldo-esque. Great header. Just past the post. Unlucky, mate. But how decisive will that be? 9 minutes to go. Few minutes to go. And I have to say, Fabio Alvarez in the midfield, he hasn't done anything spectacular, but he's been really solid. And he's going to be really instrumental, I think, at the back end of this season. He's on the ball here. He's done really freaking well. He's been crunched. He's still got the ball. Wow! Have we found ourselves a gem again from the Youth Academy? Reader finds Stewart. Blocked. Ref, please. Full-time whistle, please. Yes, there we go. The Stadium of Light erupts again this season. A clean sheet for us today, boys. We defeat Watford 1-0. Yes, we really needed that win. We really did. And we have performed so well during this episode. It's going to be difficult games. We're going to lose games. We're going to drop points where we shouldn't. But I have to say, on our returning season to the Premier League, this group of players have done themselves proud. He have done the fans proud. Another win in the books. And just a few days on from that win against Watford, we're down at Brighton. Normally sunny Brighton today, though, wet and windy away from home down here on the coast. We take on a really good side under the leadership of Graham Potter, but we are a really good side as well. We're going to stick with the exact team we just used for the Watford game. So Fabio Alvarez keeps his place. Rieder and Cook are still out. Bella Kotchap remains at the back alongside Matheson. We kept a clean sheet, so no need to change. Maksimovic on the ball. Carvalho here. Lamptey really high up the pitch for Brighton. Carvalho again getting forwards into Lamptey. Good play from Brighton this. Potential here for Brighton. Maksimovic, Lamptey can't get the ball. And Collins denies them. Big save from our keeper. And that's a nice touch from Samuel Lambert. That may set us on a counter-attack. Cucurella is getting back. Fabio Alvarez in towards Riley. Switch it out to the other wing, please, lads. Dottardian here on the ball. Back in towards Peter Riley. Not much going on in the midfield for us. Fabio Alvarez, though, on the ball. Really good bit of possession, though, from us. I thought I'd lose the ball by now. Oh, Gelhardt nearly turns into a bit of space. Samuel Lambert doesn't give up on it. This is an intense, really hotly battled game so far. Both teams are really going for it. Cabral to Riley to Fabio Alvarez. Why not have a goal? Oh, what a hit. This kid has something special. In a few seasons' time, he is going to be absolute brilliance. They really are on a high press. But if we can beat that press, they will be in trouble. And we have just beaten that exact press. Dottardian across for a tap-in for Riley. Let's go. This has been a cracking game so far. Both teams playing some really great stuff. Brighton have been great. We, though, have been smarter. Let them put the high press on. Few passes around the corner, in behind. Sweaty pass across, and Riley taps home for another goal this season. The man returning from his ACL, the most important player at the club, getting on the score sheet again. You love to see our number seven scoring. Yes, boys! This has been a great episode. Really enjoying the gameplay at the moment. 5 goals in 14 for this man. He is legit. 70 minutes played. Brighton have been relentless, but they have not got the goal that their possession and play deserves. Collins saves, and the rebound won't be tucked home because an offside flag rises. As I was saying, Brighton have been really, really good today. They just haven't scored the goal they need. It's the same in real life for them, and they are making a change. Capella off, Sulemana comes on. We need to make a few changes. Tired legs, Alvarez, brilliant again, off, and Lambert off as well. Few different players on the pitch here for us. I brought on Lloyd. He normally plays in attacking midfield. He will go out wide for the rest of this game. And the reliable Reader in midfield. And we're still on it here. I might have to stick with the commentary. I'm going to, because Serkin's normally got a good delivery. Looks okay. Oh, Lloyd was coming onto that perfectly. It had to be headed away. It had to be. As we head into the final 5 minutes, an enthralling game here on the coast. Really good play again. Really good play. And Whippo saved and saved again. Collins has made about 50 saves in this one. Brilliant from him again. Now Lloyd, can we now counter-attack and kill them off? This is Lloyd. Cucurella's so fast though, he's catching up. Good delivery, maybe a chance. Heading away into the final few seconds. We're hanging on in there. We're hanging on in for 3 more points this season. This team has come up from the Championship and done so much better than expected. And we are just around the corner from January. Are we going to rest on our laurels and hope that this squad has enough to continue this way for the second half of the season? Or do we dip into the January market, improve the team more with the money that we have, and continue to progress this side? Because at the moment, we're doing it at an alarming rate. We win again, 1-0. Okay then, boys. A lot of December has been played and some really brilliant results. 3 wins on the bounce in this month as well. After the defeat to Arsenal, we responded excellently. Now we have 2 weeks now, 2 weeks into the January transfer market, and we would like to potentially dip into that market, as I previously said. Now, money wise, not the biggest budget in the world. We have 9.9 million. Let's call it 10. Let's bump it up to 10. We've got 10 million. We also have players leaving us. Huggins is already going to be leaving us. I believe Willis may be leaving us. And Pirola looks like he wants his way out of the club, submitting that transfer request. So we could have maybe 15 million or so. Let me know in the comments your January transfer targets. Let's go into the squad. Squad-wise, we're okay in most positions, I would say. If there's any positions you're looking at right now and you think we need to upgrade on, you need to let me know ASAP in the comment sections of this video, please, boys. Got some really good youth players. Amato has barely played. Alvarez bursting through today. Sutton, he's continuing, hopefully, to develop a little bit faster. He's only a 58 rated at the moment. Maybe defence, maybe centre-back. We need another young centre-back, potentially. You boys need to let me know. So observe the team. Pause the video, whatever you need to do. Look at the team I've just showed you there and make a decision. Drop your comments below and your reasons why as well, boys. So far this season then, we are absolutely delivering. And I said about avoiding relegation. At the minute, we're sixth. Sixth! Sunderland! On their first season back in the Prem. What? Unbelievable. We could push for Europe this season. Next year, we could be playing either Conference or Europa League. I don't think we're going to get in the top four. If we did, that'd be ridiculous. But getting in the other European competitions isn't out of the question. With a shrewd move in January, it could happen. Really enjoyed this episode, boys. I really do hope you have. If you could smash that like button for me, I really appreciate it. The comment as well always helps. Subscribe if you're new. And before we go, player of the episode. Do you know what? There's been some really good players today, but I'm going to go with a young man who just burst onto the scene. Burst onto the scene and had really good performances against difficult opponents and kept Reader and Cook out of the team. Fabio Alvarez, 19 years of age from Brazil, 66 overall. He will grow quick. He's a shining star, another shining star from our youth academy. Can't wait to see him grow, boys. Player of the episode, lad. Congratulations. Thank you for watching, and boys, until next time, take it easy, and peace.